The U-2 presented enormous challenges to its creators. To climb high, it had to be light. At the same time, it had to carry a heavy fuel load for long range. A medium-powered turbojet is adequate to lift it. The engine can be shut off, so it can glide and travel long distances. The U-2 is a sailplane with a jet engine.
You know, on the other end, down low, how is it down there?
Down low, it's a real truck. it flies like for anybody who's flown a heavy aircraft, it flies just like a heavy, although it wouldn't be categorized as a heavy aircraft. Very slow roll and pitch inputs and responses, very heavy control forces. It's all cable pulling, no hydraulic backup.
Well, some of our sailplane pilots will
sure,
recognize
sure, but it's even heavier than the heaviest sailplane you've ever flown. I've got a little bit of KC-135 time just here and there, and very similar to that, in fact, maybe even heavier. So it's a very stiff, heavy, physical airplane to operate.
On landing, I noted that there was a car trailing along on the runway. What's the purpose of that car?
Well, first of all, that driver of that car is a U-2 pilot himself.
Oh, yeah.
So that's one of our additional duties, and it's a 5-liter Mustang. He's essentially a safety observer. And on operational sorties, he's also your supervisor of flying. He's keeping an eye on the weather, changes at the airfield, keeping his pilot abreast of any changes going on.
Kind of like the instructor pilot during a solo,
you betcha.
Solo flight.
You bet, he sure is. But here in a low sortie, the mission of that chase car, and he does enter the runway with the airplane, is to call your altitude from the main gear to the runway, starting from 10 feet and down. And because it's so critical in this airplane to get that tailwheel down first and land in the proper attitude without any crab at all, he's there to assist in achieving that goal in the landing. We do practice what we call no-voice landings in the final turn. We'll call base gear down, no voice, and he won't make any calls. So we do practice because sometimes the cars spin out in the rain, or if you have to divert, you're obviously not going to have a chase car. But where that guy really comes into play is on a 9-hour-plus operational sortie. You've been in a spacesuit the whole time. You're fatigued. Your brain is starting to lose its effectiveness. You've got 200-foot ceiling and a half a mile of visibility and maximum crosswinds. You need that little bit of moral support to help you get this particular beast to the ground, and that's that guy's role.
Another piece of information.
Sure is. You betcha.
And I understand that landing really isn't over after you've touched down.
Until you're in the chocks, like any tail dragger pilot knows.